Parking tickets. I can't stand parking tickets. Pretty disappointing, and people should try to obey the laws.
And plugging the meters would help plug the budget. Cincinnati's trying to plug a $60 million budget gap, and News 5 has uncovered millions of dollars it's not even collecting.
News 5's Amy Wagner has been investigating this for months. Today, she tracked down some of the biggest perpetrators. She's live with a story you'll see only on News 5. Amy?
Well, Cheryl, that's right. We're talking about unpaid parking tickets. This huge stack of papers is a list from last year alone. In all, we're talking about nearly $4.5 million just from 2007 through 2009.
Well, it's pretty astounding.
Cincinnati Council member Jeff Birding knows unpaid parking tickets are a problem in Cincinnati, but he didn't know how bad until we brought the problem straight to him.
Well, the people who are, do we respect, deadbeats, are passing the costs of the city services on to everyone else.
When I first started investigating this issue 3 months ago, city representatives had trouble even pinpointing who was in charge of unpaid tickets. But today, a spokeswoman told me this year the city hired a collection agency, that the agency has an 80% collection rate and has brought in $4 million. If that's the case, we found thousands of others who still aren't paying up, and we wondered how hard they are to track down. It turns out number 85 for the Bengals has 2 unpaid parking tickets. Enterprise Rent-A-Car, 20.
Have you ever even been aware of an issue with unpaid parking tickets?
Timothy Larson owes the city hundreds of dollars for his 7 unpaid parking tickets. We easily tracked down his parents' house today and talked to his brother, who knew all about the unpaid tickets.
Well, he's got a number of unpaid parking tickets.
Yeah.
But the city says the biggest issue is offenders from out of state, because fees to collect that money often cost more than the ticket itself. Still, with layoffs looming for city workers, at least one council member believes the current collection method should be parked while they search for a better way.
And certainly, if we could receive half of the money due, a couple million dollars, we might be able to avoid laying off police or firefighters, and that's to the benefit of the whole city.
Now, we did ask somebody from the city to sit down and talk to us today about their collection methods, but they say they couldn't make anybody available until tomorrow. Meanwhile, Jeff Birding says he'll propose the idea of an amnesty day to try to recoup some of this money the city is owed. Reporting live tonight downtown, I'm Amy Wagner, News 5.